It is such a blessing to be able to walk into this week knowing that we are dealing with destiny supply, a God who supplies all our needs according to his riches in glory. Today we want to talk about tapping into the resources of God. We already know that God is a supplier. We already know that God's storehouse is a storehouse of abundance. But one question we ask is, how do we tap into those resources? How do we get what God has to become ours? Jesus was able to answer this in the scripture in Matthew chapter 7, verse 7 and 8. And this is what he said. He said, "Ask, and it shall be given to you. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and the door shall be opened to you. For whoever asks, receives. Whoever seeks, finds. And whoever knocks at the door, it shall be opened to them." Jesus used these three doors to enable us to know how to tap into the resources of God. We start with the first one, and it's a simple one. Ask. You need resources. You need to tap into what God has. Very simple. Ask. Now, asking deals with requests. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 and 7, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God that passes all understanding will keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." Many times we fail because we basically don't ask. We believe that God is not going to give, and yet Jesus said, "Ask, and it shall be given to you." God is waiting. Sometimes people say, "Now if God knows what I need, why doesn't he just go ahead and give it to me?" God has given us this principle to tap into those resources. He simply says, "Ask, and guess what? It shall be given to you." And then he says, "But whoever asks, receives." In other words, it is guaranteed for sure that if you go to God and ask him according to his will, he will surely give it to you. But secondly, he talks about seeking. He says, "Seek and you shall find." Matthew 6:33, Jesus was talking about the basic needs of a human being. And he says, "Don't worry about what you're going to eat. Don't worry about what you're going to drink. Don't worry about what you're going to wear. Where you're going to stay." And then he said that the heathen look for all these things. Then in verse 33, he said, "But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." In this particular statement, he's talking about seeking so that you can know the purposes of God. When you ask, he gives you your requests. When you seek, he gives you purpose. He shows you why you need these things. And when you seek his kingdom and his way of doing things, the purposes of God will become clear. He says that whoever seeks will find. You'll be able to understand why certain things are needed and why you need them. Because many times what we think we need, we actually, they are our wants. We want them. I want this, I want that, I want this. When we actually don't need them. But when you seek the kingdom, God gives you the why. He gives you purposes. And you're able to know that what you're asking for will come at a particular time and it will fulfill what God wants to do in your life. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 says, "I know the plans I have for you, plans for welfare, not for evil, to give you a future and a hope." And then he says, "And you shall seek me, and you shall search me, and you shall seek me with all your heart, and you shall find me." So, looking for purposes, seek God. But thirdly, how do you tap into the resources of God? Number one, ask. Number two, seek. But thirdly, knock. When you knock, what happens is that you enter into the throne of grace. Hebrews 4:16, he says, "Draw nigh to the throne of grace with boldness, that you may obtain mercy and find grace in time of need." You see, you're not just knocking and entering into your neighbor's house. You are knocking and entering into the throne room of God. where God himself sits. And God is waiting for you. He's a father. And as a father, Jesus said, when you pray, say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Then he says, give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. Deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. When you knock, you are entering into the Father's presence. And the Father loves you, and the Father cares for you, and the Father is willing to provide for you everything that you need. So how do you tap into the resources of God? Number one, ask. It shall be given to you. Number two, seek, and you shall find the purposes of God. Number three, knock, and you shall obtain mercy and find grace in time of need. May God richly bless you as you tap into God's abundant resources. God bless you.